I was going to Southend with a few of my friends and my little one, and there's police officers at the roundabout. It was like a big roundabout just before you get into Southend off the motorway, and then I literally crashed right in front of the coppers, and I was at fault, I think. I can't remember, I had a bit of a concussion and things, but yeah, I came quite fast. I didn't realise the police were slowing people down, and I was just going, and I think with this, that's probably the closest I feel like I've been close to death, and I would have been responsible. But it's quite a scary story, because I couldn't believe how fast I was going, and I didn't realise, somehow managed to slow it down, and right in front of coppers as well, and so I was in a bit of trouble, but since then I've become very, very sensible, and you know, I watch my speed, and yeah, that's the story, is be safe.
This is a picture of me. This is the lift. What it is, just before I had my son, he's 15 now, I was going to my sister-in-law's house, and while going there, I got in the lift, and I actually got stuck in the lift, and I was in there for about 15 minutes. I was pressing the bell, just asking for help, someone to come, and I was about 8 months pregnant at the time. And what happened was someone heard me shouting, so they said, don't panic, be calling the fire brigade. The fire brigade came and they opened the, because I was stuck in between floors. Now the fire brigade said, put your hand up and I will pull you out. I goes, I don't think that's going to be possible because I'm not well, I'm pregnant. So they said, don't worry. I goes, I'm really heavy. Don't worry, we've pulled up bigger people than that, but somehow they managed and they pulled me out, and I kept saying, like, be careful because I want to get out in one piece. not in two pieces, but yeah, it was that's it. They pulled me out and I went to my sister-in-law's house.
Brilliant.
In one piece.
And so this is the story of me making my story called The Two Lovebirds. So one day, my mum was ill and she was lying down on the couch and she was watching TV, and she called me so many times, like several times, and I say, I'm coming, and I think in my head, just stop calling me, because I couldn't finish my story, and it took me a week to finish it, and this is me going down the stairs, and I have this picture because every day I look out the window and I see like loads of buildings, and it just reminds me of Allah's beauty.
Thank you. So this is what it was on top. So this represents my older sister, myself and my younger sister. So when we were little, we were like glued together. We were like three musketeers. So whatever we did, wherever we were always stuck together. And one of the jobs we had to do was when a guest came, we had to kind of like make the tea. So we didn't want to waste time doing that. So as soon as they stepped through the door, we run down, someone says they're going to put the kettle on and sort the cup out, that I would just mix it, and my younger sister would just take it to the guest. So as soon as they'd come in, they'd sat down and the tea set, and we'd run back up, all three of us. So it was just...
They probably know what happened.
They didn't know what hit them, yeah. They didn't know what hit them. This thunderstorm came, gave us a cup of tea, and they ran back out. But it was this thing that we were always together. It was just the best days of our childhood before we all got married. And there was a point where it actually used to irritate our dad, so he'd want to separate us just to see what would happen. But we were just so glued together, wasn't we? It was really lovely that time.